Hello and welcome to Newsclick. 33 years ago, Bhopal was struck by a terrible tragedy, a massive gas leak. This toxic gas spread across more than half the city, leaving 5.5 lakh people injured and killing 20,000 people over the next several years. Today we have with us ND Jayaprakash from the Bhopal Gas Peedith Sangharsh Sahayog Samiti. He is here to discuss what the current state of the victims is and how this is still being neglected by the state. Welcome, sir. So it's been 33 years and we see that the victims have still not been given adequate compensation. They still are not, you know, able to afford the healthcare or lead dignified lives. So what is the state of this compensation? What is the current status of this?
Roughly in injury cases, those victims got 50,000. And in death cases, they were given average 1 lakh each. But subsequently in 2010, Government of India, on its own, decided to raise compensation in death cases to 10 lakhs. That was in 2010. Also in 2010, the Government of India filed a curative petition against the settlement, and which they claimed another additional 7,000 crores. But that curative petition, which was filed in 2010, is still pending before the Supreme Court. But before the Supreme Court, before the Government of India filed the case before the Supreme Court, Bhopal Gas Peedith Sangharsh Sahayog Samiti and the Bhopal Gas Peedith Mahila Udyog Sangathan, we had challenged the settlement earlier, and it was on the basis that the whole thing was reopened, and we questioned the number of victims, because the settlement was based on the assumption that only 1 lakh 5,000 victims, including 3,000 dead, were dead and injured. You know, but in 2004, the government itself, the claims courts, determined that there were more than 5,73,000. So we said that accordingly, because the government itself has admitted that the magnitude was 5 times higher than the basis of the settlement, the compensation also should be proportionately increased. So that was filed. Initially, the Supreme Court dismissed it. Then we went to the we were given the opportunity of going back to the Welfare Commissioner's office. Welfare Commission also dismissed it. Then went to High Court dismissed it. We came back to the Supreme Court, and finally, our petition was again admitted. Okay. But that is also pending before the Supreme Court. Still pending. So that's the state of.
And we also see that the government, the health facilities which have been provided to these victims are not adequate. They're not maintaining proper records, which has also been seen as a way, as a hindrance in the way to get the compensation.
Yeah, because see, when the victims had gone before the claim courts, they had no proof of degree of injury, because the records were supposed to be maintained by the government. Okay. But that they could not prove for the court the degree of injury. That is why most of the victims were classified as temporarily injured. Mm-hmm. There was absolutely no basis. Then we have been repeatedly demanding that the medical records be computerized. Mm-hmm. And the other problem was, you see, there were about 7-8 major hospitals. I mean, there were about with 1,000 beds, mm-hmm. exclusive for gas victims. Okay. plus a number of clinics. So the victims used to go to one hospital a day, or one day, take medicine from there. Then next day they would go to another hospital, take more medicines. There was no record of what they were consuming. You know, okay. You know, it was all symptomatic treatment. You know, there was no proper diagnosis and investigation. So we said the records must be properly computerized, and only referral cases should go to, from clinics should go to the tertiary care, you know, for higher proper investigation and diagnosis and treatment. Subsequently, Supreme Court in 2001 had directed the state government to computerize the medical records. But the fact is till today, last 15 years, when about 16 years, it has not been completed. You know, they were trying to hide the facts, you know, because maintaining records would prove the degree of injuries of the gas victims. And so they wanted to hide this fact. And so they've been messing up with the process of computerization and proper record keeping.
Yeah, so they won't have to pay as much compensation.
But because of, finally in 2012, again the Supreme Court gave a very strong direction to the state government and the government of India to ensure that the records are properly computerized. But the matter is still pending before the, and the Supreme Court sent the case back to the High Court. And the matter is still pending there. The state government and the biggest hospital which is treating Bhopal gas victims is the Bhopal Memorial Hospital. They claim that they have records of 370 odd victims. And out of that, the latest information we have got is that 170,000 victims have been regularly visiting this hospital for the last 17 years, because the Bhopal Memorial Hospital was set up in 2000. So, because even in the curative petition, the government of India has only claimed that only 4,000 odd victims are seriously injured.
Okay. Others are all temporarily injured
for 33 years. And I mean, the ridiculousness of the entire.
And coming to the otherwise, the criminal proceedings. So we see the blame game is still on. Still no one has really been accused and like properly incriminated in this case. And there is a case of Keshab Mahindra, who was the chairman of Union Carbide India at that time. And so earlier he had claimed sabotage for the reason of this gas leak. And now we see that this is again coming up. So what is this whole sabotage claim and why is it coming up again?
The Indian accused had never raised the issue of sabotage earlier. Okay. It's only last month when the matter came up for the Sessions Court that they have issued. Earlier, Union Carbide Corporation had indirectly raised the issue of sabotage. But Union Carbide India Limited had never raised this issue. And they, none of the Indian accused when the matter was before the CJM, Chief Judicial Magistrate, and they had never raised this issue at all. So now this has been raised in order to divert the whole issue. Because our contention has been the disaster took place because of improper safety systems. Because there was another plant in the United States, because the Bhopal is the sister plant of the plant which was there already there. The safety systems in the Bhopal, in the Union Carbide plant in the United States is of a higher degree. And the safety systems at the Bhopal plant are substandard. So it's a clear case of double standards. And the disaster took place because of adoption of double safety standards. That has been our contention. So in order to divert this issue, they're raising the issue of sabotage. They were storing highly toxic chemicals, So there should have been maximum security. You cannot just any employee cannot play around with 40 tons of chemicals stored in a place. So even if the question of sabotage comes up, it's a question, how did you permit somebody to carry out such a sabotage? So that means your safety systems were not proper.
Finally, we should also discuss the contamination of the site. So we see that it's still quite awful. This water in the area is polluted and there's toxic waste. The problem of toxic waste has not still been dealt with. So what is being done really? What are the efforts which are being done to decontaminate this area?
Nothing has been done so far. We got to know that a lot of chemicals had been stored, unused chemicals had been stored within the plant. Okay. And we also came to know that they were not properly secured. And many of these old chemicals which are lying on the plant premises was leaching into the ground. So on this basis that the Pollution Control Board submitted a report before the court. And that is when we came to, became more aware of the gravity of the issue. Mm. Then Greenpeace had carried out certain studies which proved that a lot of toxic waste had gone to the ground and contaminated the water and soil. Mm. And we also came to know about the solar evaporation pond, which was outside the factory premises,
okay,
which where they were dumping toxic waste from 1969,
okay,
from the time the plant was set up.
Hmm.
And a lot of that chemical, in the pond, they just laid a polythene sheet, you know, and just dumping chemicals on that, you know. And so over a period of time that, you know, plastic sheets just gave away and the chemicals released into the ground.
Hmm.
So subsequently, NIRI, the National Institute of Environmental Research,
hmm,
they've carried out studies which has pointed out that the 1.1 million tons of contaminated soil,
mm-hmm,
is there in and around the plant, and nearly 345 tons of chemical waste is still stored within the plant premises.
Okay.
And the issue of providing safe water to the residents who are nearby, because a lot of people are depending on hand pumps,
okay,
for water. So again, after intervention before the court, the court has directed the government to give pipe water to the residents in and around the plant. So that has not been completely carried out by the government yet. They're saying that they're still in the process of providing safe water to the gas victims.
So we see that even after 33 years, there's a lot which has to be done. And how, like, because of this pollution problem, this gas leak is continuing to impact people who are living there now.
See, and this the medical issues is a very serious thing, because proper research has not been carried out.
Hmm.
Although, you know, nobody knows what are the real implications of the exposure to this toxic materials, you know, because the ICMR had stopped all research in 1994.
Okay.
See, and it's only after our intervention that they started. Again, they restarted the research work in 2010, you know.
Hmm.
You know, and even the last 7 years, not much work has been done yet, you know. And we've always demanded that the victims be given the best treatment.
Hmm.
See? And in between, the large number of doctors, senior consultants from Bhopal Memorial Hospital left the hospital and went, because they were all on contract basis.
Okay.
Because there was no, because we said it should be at par with the best treatment which is available in India.
Mm.
We said it should be part of AIMS,
mm,
or Indian Institute, because subsequently they did set up an AIMS unit in Bhopal. But they had not made BMHRC a part of AIMS.
Okay.
So after our intervention, finally the government has agreed that Bhopal Memorial Hospital would be made part of AIMS. But they have not, the health ministry has agreed to it, but the cabinet has not yet sanctioned that. And the Madhya Pradesh High Court has given the health ministry time till 8th January to fulfill this condition, you know, because there is no central health service scheme, you know,
mm-hmm,
in the BMHRC at present, because of which the government and the doctors are unwilling to remain there.
Okay, so that's all the time we have.
Yeah.
Thank you, for joining us and talking to us about all of these issues. Thank you for watching Newsclick.